Okay, so, we are watching Chuck's Flower versus Seabag. Chuck's Flower is on Sync and Seabag is on Andromeda. Oh, too bad we missed the perfect Andromeda. Big hand 9 card opening. But it seems like this Sync is also on Breaking News, which is nothing unexpected. But it's also on Explodapalooza. The Sync is already on 4 agenda points. Seabag is on 1 agenda point, but has a turning wheel with 5 counters already. We have quite some rest eyes, but on both sides we have rather a lower credit count. We see an install into the server. It's protected by a data raven and an unknown eyes. Looks like we just missed the purge here from the Aumakua. Let's check archives. Okay, we have a best defense, economic warfare, and hard hitting news. Okay, nothing unexpected from Sync, I would say. Best defense is fun. Pretty much a tech card against the No One Home, I'm guessing, and misdirection. And on the runner side, we've seen a lot of economy and a No One Home. I'm guessing the No One Home was really trashed by the best defense. Oh man, too bad we didn't watch this from the beginning, but okay. Chuck's Flower is drawing. So what do you do here? You have the Mausolus on R&D. You can just bum rush it just to get some counters, but you will need a lot of counters until you can contest either R&D or HQ with your Aumakua. So Seabag is deciding to just go for a blind diversion of funds. It's another Mausolus, which brings Chuck's Flower down to 1 credit, but I think she's fine with that. With a rest Mausolus, the Mausolus will fire, giving attack, making a net damage. That was trashing up his bones. I think you can just check out, don't you? Do you really want to keep on going here with the diversion? The slot machine revealed a rebirth, which is fine. In Andromeda, cool idea to rebirth. Still using the diversion to steal all of Chuck's Flower's money. I said Chuck's Flower right now, losing a few credits. Okay, this brought her down to 0 credits. I think she's just clicking up. Too bad there's no Rashida in server 1. But still only 16 cards left in R&D, so there is not too much time anymore, I think. Agendas needs to be somewhere also. Maybe there are already a few agendas in archives left, because there are 3 face down cards. There's the hunting grounds, there's the tech for the data raven or for the slot machine, pretty good against NBN in general. Or you use it against the IP block to not get another tech. So what do you do here? You can break the IP block. Good question. Yeah, well, you use the hunting grounds right now, so you don't get the tag. Then you trace, then you remove the tag, I would say. Oh, he's removing the tag? Oh, he wasn't tagged. Okay. Okay, using hunting grounds. Afterwards, I think you can just bounce from the data raven. Wondering what kind of breakers Andromeda here is running. I'm pretty sure she is running at least some backup breakers to the turtle. Turtle only is a bit dangerous. And there is no throwback surprise card, because it's already Andromeda. There is already enough surprise. But Seabag has a good credit lead. Maybe he will find some way through the Mausolus on R&D and can check 4 cards with all those turning wheel tokens. And Andromeda is installing the classic. Help yourself drawing through your deck. Okay, there's another breaking news, I guess. No. What is this? Is it NGO? So, and server, that does mean that server 1 is either an agenda or an asset. If server 2 is an NGO, otherwise she would have absolutely slammed the NGO in server 1. Even if it's a trap, it can't be too bad. I would check it, click 1. Just to make sure there are no secrets on the board. In general, I think... do you really want to dirty laundry this? If it's an NGO, the dirty laundry will whiff because there is no successful run because there is no more server. So you better... No, okay. Taking this back, dirty laundry on server 1. So ZBag is also guessing that this is an agenda in server 1. Might be another exploder palooza, just as a bait. Okay, using hunting grounds to not get attacked by the armor core, tracing through the IP block through the first sub, second sub is irrelevant here. Need to take a tag from the data raven and another trace. So this is pretty expensive, to be honest. Oh, and it's a Bellona. Oh no, that's the worst case. That's the worst case. Poor Z-Bag, don't have the 5 credits. Okay, but there is the Deuces Wild for the help to remove the tag here. So many tags today, so many tags. So, it was an NGO. And we see two Riziki. So, Z-Bag is going for the long game. He has only 14 cards left in R&D, so the game won't be that long, I'm guessing. And the winning agenda is in server 1 also. I don't know if Z-Bag might have thrown this here. Another economic warfare, so Z-Bag now is on a very low credit count. He needs 5 credits left after he passes both eyes. He needs at least three for the IP block and at least 3 for the... Oh no, it's 2. Oh, Andromeda has a link. Yes, so it's 4 credits at least. Chuck's Flower can boost by 4. So that this could be 8 credits, and with the Bellona 13 credits. So running below 13 credits can be scary. Otherwise you lose. I don't know that both the two Riziki installs. Okay, so it's running there. Oh no. That's not true because Chuck's Flower needs 3 credits to score her Bellona. That does mean she can only pump 1 trace by 1. Which would be obviously the IP block trace. That does mean it's a 3, 5, 10 credits. So click for 3 credits and run. Oh no, you can't do this. Then you end up tagged with the data raven. Oh, that is a very... This is a very tough situation. This is a very tough situation. Maybe there are something to help out here. Maybe there are stim hacks. Maybe he can do a bravado somewhere on some of the eyes. Dirty laundry is a bit of a problem right now. Sure, gamble have been played 3 already. So he's straightly going into the diversion, which is also an okay idea. I don't know if this... Totally depends on what the slot machine is doing. So if the slot machine is giving the corp 3 credits, the whole diversion... he might up Might end up getting tag me here. But I don't know. Do a diversion of funds for 2 clicks and a credit to make the corp lose 5 while the corp is gaining 4. It's a slot machine and a Mausolus. So okay, the top cards are an event, a hardware and a resource. Okay, that was lucky. Whoo. So he can either decide to remove the tag and run server 1 next turn, because Chuck's Flower has no way of scoring the Villona in one turn, or he goes for it right now and end up being tagged here this turn. Also giving a good long hard think. So there are 3 Bellonas. 3 of the Exploder Palooza, which I also haven't seen in quite some time. And 3 breaking news, which is exactly 18. I don't know. Is Exploder Palooza so much better than Beal in those decks? I don't know. Okay, Zbeck is drawing up and has 1 click left. 1 click left, and the click is doing a Deuces Wild to gain some money and remove the tag. Okay, so he is. Next turn he can run into server 1. Chuck's Flower obviously need to click for 3 credits. There is not much options left if she wants to put up the pressure. There is no more tag. Another economic warfare, okay, that's not too bad, but there's still Risikis ticking up here. And Chuck's Flower is only on 2 credits here. I think Zbeck has one whole turn again to do whatever he wants to, maybe just moneying up and then going into server 1 next turn. You might consider that there is another Bellona in hand, maybe, that is ending up getting installed into server 1 the turn after this one gets stolen. So I would rather concentrate on only clicking for credits here. I don't know if there is any card besides the last Deuces Wild that is giving you credits without running. You can sit back on your Risikis and click up to 10 here. That Amakua is starting to become more and more of a liability with that IP block. Just eating up the precious hunting grounds trigger that you really need for the State the Raven. Deciding to take a tag and let the trace fires. And the link from Andromeda really helps you a lot. Really saves you a lot of money. Okay, stealing the Bellona. At least now the Bellona threat is gone, but the Data Raven now has an agenda counter, and that is always terrible. So but Zbeck is already on 1 tag, so a high profile target is enough to kill, and a Scorched Earth is also enough, and Chuck's Flower, if she has one of the 2 cards in hand, it's GG. Okay, he has 2 clicks left. What you gonna do with the 2 clicks? You might Might want to run R&D, yes, yes, and take all your turning wheel tokens before you might lose it next turn. So there was it uses wild. Okay, and this time we will see 1, 2, 3, 4 cards from 13 left. No Bellona credits. Access nothing. Oh my god. Oh my goodness. They might be all in archives or in HQ. Wow. So now where now that you are tagged, you can just face plant archives, I think. The additional tag from the turnbike don't count too much. Oh wow. Oh man. It always feels so bad with seven counters on the turning wheel and you pay 6 counters to see 3 additional cards and there's just nothing. Okay. Flipping the sync identity. Cool. That does mean it doesn't cost anything to trash an resource when your runner is tagged. Trashing the turning wheel. I think trashing the hunting grounds would also be very useful. But maybe next turn. And also not flipping back the identity. So the two tags can be removed with 4 credits and not with the additional credit from the other side of the flip identity. I really want to know what Z-Bag was accessing here on R&D. Okay, he was on very low credits. But I can't imagine this was all ice and operations, because there's still Rashida and 2 NGOs missing. Z-Bag is drawing up here. Installing a boomerang, okay, on the HQ ice, alright. He might want to take the tech. Because one of the subs needs to be fired. Because boomerang is only breaking 2 subs. Okay, approaching the slot machine, using the hunting grounds, which is also okay. Losing 3, which means losing 1, if you have only a single credit left. I'm checking HQ and go in here for the luck. I hope this is no Bellona. Accessing a preemptive action. Hui. So this does mean if there's agendas and archives, Chuck's Flower can just reshuffle them. You don't care about the tags anymore. You have 3 tags and they're still the data rifle. So for any kind of tag punishment, you are open. You're open all game long. I don't think Andy has any way to trash the data raven with the counter on it. Okay, there is the best defense, that is reshuffling a best defense, a Rashida, and 1 unseen, back into R&D. Okay, so, the Amakua is on a 3 token right now, not too much of a board state from Andy here. And if you... Once you might hit the 5 Amakua tokens, Chuck's Flower might purge them away. Next turn, she's maybe slamming the winning Bellona in server 1. The Data Raven might be kind of a blank card for the moment. Seabag decided to stick to the tags, but the IP block, the end the run, if the runner is tagged, is still something that needs to be considered and that needs to be broken by Seabag before he can get into server 1, no matter if he's tagged or not. Seabag is drawing up here. The class act still alive. The hunting grounds now got trashed by Chuck's flower. Yeah, she really needs to get rid of it. Okay, and there's the dirty laundry. Dirty laundry and archives. Yes. Get everything fire here. Let's gain another tag, yeah. Nothing in archives. What do we see here? Another data raven, a hard hitting muse, and a resistor. I think resistor is not too bad for the moment. Okay, so now Amakua is hitting the magic number 4, breaking the IP block. Yeah, so now she is purging away the tokens. She might want to slam the Bellona into server 1 and go install double advance and just go for it. Okay, there were boomerangs. So server 1 is nothing too safe. It's not safe at all. You can try because, like I said, there's 2 NGOs left, supposedly. You can just try to fake out an NGO, or you can really put an NGO into the air just to make Andromeda run that server. But first of all, you need to get rid of the Aumakua tokens, which is the absolute right decision. Riziki is still ticking here. Runner is just clicking up for credits, I don't know. He really needs to find a way into server 1. Maybe he already has the boomerang in hand and is feeling safe. So where is all the tech punishment? This is Sync, there can't be only hard-hitting news and economic warfare. So what do you do when the runner goes tagging? It's also the question, how do you tag the runner, and when the runner is tagged, what do you do to punish the runner? Another purge. Okay. Were there even Aumakua tokens? Oh. I think this was a misclick. Drawing a card. Seems like she don't have the winning Bellona on hand, or she might looking for another ice. Okay, money up here and install into server 1. I think she reshuffled a Rashida with the preemptive. This might be a Rashida. Okay, here's an Angolo, trashing the armor core, the liability core. Okay, what do you do with Angolo? You only can see a single card. Okay, Bravado R&D. That Mausolus still costs some money. Okay, let fire all. It's rushing the beautiful Paragon. I want to keep the Paragon like it seems. Getting her credit, stacking up the tags to 5, access an unseen card. Nothing. Where are those agendas hiding? Where are they hiding? Checking server 1. Okay, now at least Seebeck has a safety way to go through the IP block with the Angelo by painting it to a code gate. He can the can just can go through the data raven, getting so much tags as he wants. I think it doesn't matter anymore if you have four, five, or six tags. The amount of tags mostly only matters at the range of 0, 1 or 2. You either have 0, 1 or 2, and if you have more than 2, it doesn't matter how much you have mostly. There are cards that are interacting with the amount of tags, like psychographics or the market forces that we have seen in round 2, I think. But those are niche cards. You won't see them too often. Okay, and is it the Rashida? It's the breaking news. Why not? Why not? Okay, but this does mean that the last Explodapalooza would also be the winning agenda for Seebeck. This was still a good fake, costing the runner some money. Just moneying up here. So where are the outs? Where are the outs? You might also want to trash the classic just with a click, I think. Still drawing, still drawing. So, but now your Bellona plan is not too safe anymore. I think the window is gone right now, now that Angelo hits the table and might just kick through the IP block. Okay, this is pretty much telegraphing that the winning agenda is already in HQ. Only 8 cards left, so at one point of time, Chuck's Flower needs to slam it into server 1. I don't think Seebeck has to do anything here. He just can sit back on his Riseki, just click for credits. Maybe Chuck's Flower is waiting for this because she has closed accounts on hand. Still filter drawing here with the class act. Going for R&D here again. Cards fire again. Thrashing the rebirth. And accessing nothing. You can rebirth? Let me read that card for a second. Switch your identity with another identity from the same faction. So, what would you rebirth into? What would be useful here? Lila is not useful because both are on game points. I think Gabe is also not useful because HQ is so heavily defended already. Yeah, maybe that was the idea of Seebeck also. Was thinking about what can I rebirth into? Is it even worth anymore that late in the game to rebirth into something else? Running here a big bad resistor. Let's talk about the amount of tags again. Yeah, Resistor is one of the cards. Okay, this needs to be boosted twice by the Angolo. That is pretty expensive. That's 7 credits for that stupid Resistor. Or you might just want to trace through. This might be cheaper. It's only an end the run trace. I don't know. Just let the trace fire. Four, six, seven. Yeah, with 7 you could boost up to trace 8. I don't know. Maybe he was missing this. Maybe he wanted to be sure to get through HQ. Okay, getting another Paragon trashed. singer, Earthrise Hotel, a Innes informant and a political operative. Okay, so to pull up another attack for the Caprice Nisei or for the fear of Caprice Nisei and approaching HQ and accessing the exchange of information. That exchange is not too useful yet. I'm wondering why Chuck's Flower just didn't. Oh, there's the boom. Okay. why she didn't was scoring the breaking news out of hand. If she knew that there was an exchange, because she could have exchanged the breaking news for the Bellona and just win. Maybe she was trying this, maybe she was too late, but yeah, hey. There was the boom. The rocket kills Andy. That happens when you're attacked against Zink. GG, well played. Okay, maybe they are playing the second round. Round two? No, not round two, game two. Yes, yes, I was thinking in the break. In German we say Hinrunde and Rückrunde, or maybe Rückrunde, but in English I wasn't sure. So it's just game one and game two. It's no rematch or regame or something like that. I will just stick to round one and round two. So I think they won't play the rematch. This was also a 2-for-1. Oh no, this wasn't. Cool. And this time we have Chuck's Flower also on Andy, cool. And Zbeck is playing Haas Bioroid, HP Engineering the Future. So both identities, that is already already the throwback card. I don't know how good is Engineering the Future still. Is it better than Arza? Is it better than Arza? We will see. Both kept their hand. I see Becky starting with Ice on HQ, gaining the sweet, sweet ETF credit. And installing Ice on R&D and opening up an open server. Could be anything here. With Andy, you pretty much know there is a dirty laundry coming on turn one. Playing a bravado, or playing a sure gamble into a paragon and playing a bravado, just forcing the rest on HQ. Okay, there's the ginger and the gatekeeper. Okay, so the gatekeeper is gonna fire, pressing the ginger because the gatekeeper can draw up to 3 cards. Zbeck is drawing 3 cards, reveal a border control here and slamming the border control for 3 on server 1 clickless, and this is gonna be your end the run. That was cool. Okay, so now you have the ginger with the border control on top, but you don't have a good HQ ice anymore for next turn. Next turn could be diversion of funds. Very easy with a boomerang here. Okay, another gatekeeper on server 1, protecting the ginger. Installing an upgrade in HQ could also be a ginger. Still low on credits here. Okay, going for the big violet level clearance. Mudding up, drawing 4 cards. But revealing no ice. At least no ice that Zbeck want to have on server 1. So server 1 is already pretty nice. You have the one shot gatekeeper, which is still an end the run after the strength reducement and the good old border control, which will save your ass later on. So there's the Riziki ticking, we have the Paragon, maybe we see a Dirty Laundry Archives, or maybe a Pavado on R&D, just forcing some rest. Okay, Boomerang HQ. Going for the Doofarang, yes, okay. Let's see if this is really a Ginger or this might be a Chrysium Grid. This might also be, I don't know, anything. So the Doofarang goes through. Very important timing here. Really hoping for Chuxflower that she is going through with the Doofarang. And yes, it's going through. So this is obviously another Ginger. We can't be sure because the card wasn't accessed, but if it would be a Chrissy Grid or anything that would help here, I think she Seabag had already rest this one. Not the end of the world, yes, here is another Ginger. Drawing up for some oh, there's a tier. Okay, and the tier goes on HQ, but that is some ice that you won't rest that early. There is a little bit of a gap for money here until you are able to rest this one. But Silver 1 could be a Rashida, would be very helpful here. Chuxflower might to contest this one. It's only a gatekeeper and a border control. At least might force some reses here. The Dirty Laundry, okay, going on Archives, getting the Paragon trigger, getting some money, and checking the Unseen card. Okay, it's an IPO that was discarded. There's a Rebirth, okay, Rebirth into Lila that early, that's good. That's a value Rebirth for sure. That Lila will trigger at least 2 to 3 times in this game, maybe more. I don't know. I have also played Rebirth over the last few years, but I stopped playing it because all the time, if I play Rebirth, Rebirth is one of the last 5 cards in the stack and then mostly useful, useless. While when I see other people playing Rebirth, somehow they always manage to get the Rebirth quite early on. Okay, it was really a Rashida here. That helps a lot with both Ginger's rest. Okay, getting those cards installed to gain the Engineering the Future credit and moneying up and going into Hedgefall range, into IPO range, and now Seabag has the monies. Okay, another Angelo, there's the kicking man where you want to kick through. You can kick into server 1 right now if you want to. Going into Deuce is Wild, drawing the cards, classic trigger here. The Deuce is Wild, another deck where what is that is playing Deuce is Wild. Okay, for criminals it's quite obvious, but I think we haven't seen a deck today besides the Geist one that wasn't playing Deuce is Wild. Could also be another Rashida on server 1. The deck is a little bit light on ice, I would say. It's either those very cheap gear check eyes like Gatekeeper and Border Control, or we have the big bad tier, which can be rest here by the way now. Okay, another Reseeking hitting the table. Yes, yes, money is very important here, I think. Okay, drawing a Hagen, installing the Hagen, getting a credit from Engineering the Future. So now server 1 is getting pretty sick here. Ginger is just so good. Ginger is too good. I think Ginger is too good. Ginger is much too cheap to rest and much too expensive to trash. I think it should be like, I don't know, maybe 2 to rest, 3 to trash, or 3 to rest, 2 to trash, something like that. something like the old regions, like Fantasy Flight games used to print regions back in the days, not like the modern regions, which have all numbers that are just crazy. So you can face check the tier, you can click through if you want to, but we have an install double advance on server 1. It was no install, but it was a double advance on server 1. This might be... what this, could this be? There are not too much good 5 free agendas besides the Vacheron for HP, but I don't think this Engineering the Future Ginger Glacier deck is a good deck for playing Vacherons. This might be... what is this one called? Where you need to pay a click and 2 credits? Project. You know what I mean. We will see very soon what it is. Just might be an NGO, but I don't think so. I don't think this is an NGO on server 1. Okay, running on R&D here. Forcing arrest, it's a Fairchild free. Okay, you can either pay through it or you can click through it. Okay, Chucksflower deciding to pay through it. It's 5 credits. It's not too bad. Engolo is quite good against the Fairchilds in general. Accessing an unseen card, might want to do the lila magic and accessing an agenda just to bounce the card on server 1. Did not happen this time. Installing another Reseki. So, clumping up all those memory units with 3 Reseki. Okay, Z-Bag, there is a Surveyor, which is instantly a Strength 8 Surveyor once rest here with 4 eyes. And keep on advancing. No, it was an over advance Vitruvius, cool. Cool. When I would really had advanced once more, maybe. So Lila is bouncing back. At position 3, the outermost was the Surveyor. I can't remember, I think it was a Hagen that was bounced back. Okay, installing another card in server 1, at least 1 Lila trigger. But I think Lila is fine here. Lila has some setup, I don't know. Is this really? I think you have 5 MU, you already have your Paragon. Is this everything? Is this just a single Engolo? And the rest are boomerangs and maybe inside jobs? Or how is this deck breaking ice? Okay, Bravado here. There is still a Strength 6 Surveyor, I think. I think she didn't bounce the Surveyor. Maybe I was missing this. Yeah, well, I'm quite sure you want to bounce the Surveyor before you bounce the Hagen, because you're not scared of the Hagen, I think, with the Engolo. But the Surveyor is quite bad on the server, even right now. It's only 5 credits and is Strength 6. I don't know. I'm pretty sure Chucksflower was bouncing the Surveyor here. Yeah. Okay, I was missing the... or I was switching the positions of the eyes in the remote. Okay. Painting through that code gate, and the problem is there is still a border control. So Chucksflower smartly decided to check out here and just take the money and go home. There's a Rashida, okay. Rashida will work in favor here for the Gingers again. Problem is the Surveyor is now in hand and cannot be reinstalled with the Gingers if you don't somehow manage to reshuffle it from HQ into R&D. There is another Engineering the Future magic here by installing the server 1 and going for a single advance. Could be also a Vitruvius. Seems like a Vitruvius, an obvious Vitruvius play against Lila to over advance it at least once to repair some damage that was caused by the Lila bounce after the score. So at the moment there is no way into server 1 for Chuck's Flower. There is a border control into the gatekeeper, into the Hagen, and Chuck's Flower can only deal with two of those barriers. So the gatekeeper is not a problem. I don't like that Angelo now is in every deck. I think it's worse enough that there is paperclip everywhere, but the Angelo makes the gatekeeper so much worse. In the time of the restricted cards, gatekeeper really was a very good ice, because the 6 strength was for most code game breakers very expensive, but Angelo just laughing about the gatekeepers. Okay, so installing another class act over installing the old one. Okay, seems like this was either no agenda or he wants to save it some more. So we have an install into server 1. So either the card before was an upgrade or this one is an upgrade. Could be a CVS just to fake out. I don't know what the agenda suite is here for ETF. Okay, there goes the last diversion of funds. Oh, no, it's only the second one. Okay, forcing some reses here. The tier is very expensive and can be clicked through or can be painted by the Angelo and kicked through. I think I missed the last one. What was the outermost ice? Okay, the Z-Bag was installing this by hand, so the chances of this being the surveyor that was bounced from server 1 before is quite high. Otherwise, I don't think you want to install an ice on position 3. Yes, yes, with an install ginger, okay. Still not too bad. And this does mean that tier is offline. There is no more money, not enough credits to rest the tier on server position 2. That means no more action, and that means that the version is going through here. Quite expensive, but still, that was an exchange of money in favor of Chuck's Flower, for sure. And on top, the Paragon and the filter, the scrying effect, how is it called in Magic, and 2 daily casts, okay. There is a lot of money. Chuck's Flower really sitting comfortable here with 3 Rese keys. I wonder how good she is getting through the servers here only with the Angelo. I think it's very risky to leave whatever agenda is on server 1 for that long time. Maybe it's just a matter of time until Lila finds her, I don't know, Corroda or Paperclip and over-installing one of the Rese keys to being able to run into server 1. Also Inside Job would do it, a Boomerang would also do it. Okay, approaching archives here. I think just for the money, just for the Paragon trigger. Still filtering the deck. Only one agenda scored or stolen so far. Should be a lot more points in the game somewhere here. I'm wondering about the Ines informant. I haven't seen this one for quite a time. It's cool, but why? I think Aina's informant is cool when you can play 3 of them and then you have asset-based meta, but most asset-based metas are protecting their assets, like Aza, like that replicate perfection and stuff like that. It's not that easy to access those open servers or the servers at all. And as a one-off or as a two-off, it's not enough. And yeah, I don't know. I liked that card. When it was released, I played it a lot. I thought it was really cool back then. Maybe this is a good card for a Pawn Shop deck when Steve is coming back. I love Steve Cambridge Pawn Shop decks, and I think when he's coming back at the System Gateway that is coming up at any time, I think I'm gonna slam Freya Ines Informant into the deck. Oh, look at those triggers. Wow, this is a whole page of triggers here. Crazy. Okay, there was a res. Res on the Ash, so the Ash couldn't be bounced by the score of the corporate sales team, but this brings Seabag, I think, on game point. If there are real free pointers, maybe the deck is running GFI. Okay, so there's the paperclip, and he's trashing one of the Rizikis, that's fine. And there is the Miss Bones to get rid of everything that is sitting into server 1. Okay, run at server 1. He really wants to empty up those remote. You don't care about HQ too much anymore. I don't know how much HQ pressure there is at all, besides the one version of funds. Maybe you're looking for your turning wheel and start slamming R&D and just keep the remote clean. Okay, it's only a Hagen. How bad is the Hagen? It's 3 credits for Paperclip. Paperclip is gonna eat it. But that does mean... Yes, that does mean Chuck's Flower is checking out and save her last credits and wait for another turn. Die another day, Ash. Okay, another ETF, another Ginger Trigger, another Border Control. So we have all the judges join the game. What does this mean? Does it mean time is running up here? I don't know how many minutes we are in this round. I have not... Because I'm not playing, I don't care too much about the time, to be honest. Okay, now it's time around. Okay, everybody has one single turn. That means it's Chuck's Flower's last turn. So you can... What can you do? Can go for a single on R&D. So basically, Chuck's Flower need to score 5 points here in a single turn. This is pretty much the game from Z-Bag, leading with 4 agenda points here. Okay, there's another diversion. Maybe just for the lols. Seabag don't have the money for the tier. Painting through the surveyor here. I think Chuck's Flower might has struggled with finding breakers. Maybe money was not that big of a problem, and because Seabag was playing a very slow, a very steady, a very safe game here, building up his server 1, protecting HQ, resing the ISIS, don't get irritated by the lila bounces. I think Seabag has it's not over yet, but I think Seabag has done a good job here. Chuck's Flower might be a little bit too cautious with running. I don't know. We were missing multi-access at all. She was concentrating a lot on server 1, but server 1 was stiffed with barriers, and yeah. Let's see. Okay, so checks for our last turn ended. We have the last turn of Seabag. Let's see what Seabag's doing, if he's scoring. Basically, he doesn't need to do anything, just get for free credits, and it's GG. Want to end up your game with style. Chucksflower is giving the good game. Sanjay joins again and says, "What's up here? Come on, guys." Okay, is Seabag still here? I don't know what Seabag is thinking about, to be honest. He started his turn. Okay. I think this was a 2-for-1. Second game was just for fun. Thank you all for joining me. We have a single round of Swiss left, which is coming up very soon. I hope to see you there. Hope you had fun, and take care and stay safe, and bye.